Kakšen motor naj ima vaš novi avto? Električnega? No ja, se gremo v to smer. A še dalje smo v točke, ko bo množicam električni motor smisen in racionalen. Še posebej močno občutno je to tukaj na tem bolgarskem podeželju, kjer je veliko bolj tehtno vprašanje, naj ima avto bencinski ali pa dizelski motor. No in pri Mazdi trdijo, da imajo motor, ki hkrati se vrti kot bencinski motor, a hkrati nudi vse prednosti dizelsko gnanih avtomobilov.
Tudi v tem našem novem motorju imamo kompresijski vžig, ki ga pa nadzorujemo s pomočjo vžigalne svečke. Zakaj smo v igro, če lahko tako rečem, vnesli vžigalno svečko? Enostavno zato, da lahko nadzorujemo točno točko vžiga. Zdaj vžgemo mešanico ravno takrat, ko mi to želimo.
In kdaj je to?
Malo pred samo vžigom. Da lahko to naredimo, smo pa motor dodali 4 tipala, za vsak val svoje tipalo. Ne? In to tipalo v realnem času in izjemno pogosto očitava vrednosti tlaka v vsakem valju posebej.
Ključnega pomena pri tem je ravno energijska mešanica.
Lean is always the meaning of less, right? Lean means less and less is what we want to achieve, less CO2 outputs. If we naturally put less fuel in something which is more lean, in that case it means the output by having the same target as performance is naturally having lower fuel consumption.
You said there's a fireball.
The fireball is a very important part because with this fireball we are able to control when this compression ignition will happen. And when we compress this very lean mixture just towards the border of where the mixture is just not ignited, self-ignited. That means temperature and pressure are controlled under any driving condition. And then you need something which lifts this mixture to a compression ignition condition. And then we thought, why don't we use the spark plug, which we need anyway, and using a small amount of fuel atomized around the spark plug, and then using this little amount of energy to lift all the rest of the combustion chamber immediately towards a condition where compression ignition happens. Rapidly, fast and clean.
Najpomembnejšo značilnost tega motorja lahko potrdimo že po prvih testnih kilometrih.
Ta motor združuje varčno izrabo goriva dizelskega motorja, na drugi strani pa vseeno ima veselje do vrtenja in posledično čistejši izpuh bencinskega motorja. Stranka, recimo ali pa voznik, lastnik vozila, ta način delovanja med samim delovanjem motorja, uporabo vozila sploh ne bo opazil.
In na tej tehnični delavnici smo govorili tudi z profesor dr. Jamesom Turnerjem, profesorjem na univerzi v angleškem mestecu Bath. Gre za po statistikah eno najboljših univerz na svetu. No in angleški gospod se rad pohvali, da ni samo akademik, ampak da ima praktične izkušnje. Deloval je v Lotusu, Jaguar Land Roverju, v Cosworthu, bil pa tudi v motorističnih vodah, pri slovitem Nortonu.
V našo kamero nam je povedal vrsto močnih misli. V celoti vam jih ponujamo na MMC-ju, YouTubeu, Facebooku, LinkedInu, a za pokušino vam najprej ponudimo njegovo misel, s katero bencinski motori v zadnjo plat brcajo elektroavte.
It is cheap to produce. It's all made from this one, made from aluminium, iron, some plastic. There's nothing expensive in it like nickel or loads of lithium or anything like that that you have to have, or dysprosium or the rare earth elements that nobody can pronounce. So it's all cheap to make. You cast it, you machine it. We know after 120, 130 years how to control it. So although Otto would recognize the cycle that this worked on, but that's all he'd recognize. Really, they're amazing mechatronic devices now with huge control systems. And the control system in this is a world first, because now we have a pressure transducer to tell the engine management system what every combustion event is doing, and then the engine management system works out how to tweak things to bring things to where it needs to be.
In čeprav so rotacijski motori v običajnih avtih izgubili vse možnosti, da bi jih kdo kupil, pa bo Mazda svoje superiorno znanje lahko ponovno uporabila tudi v dobi elektromobilnosti.
The Wankel is quite an interesting fit, because actually its fuel consumption is not awful if you run it at its best efficiency. It is if you don't, but if you run it at its best efficiency, it's very good. And then you can look at the benefits, which are it's very compact. It has very low inertia, which is an important thing when you start and stop it from the point of view of vibration inside the cabin. And it's small and it's light. And actually, those two things mean that its installed mass in the car is low. And that is actually one of the most important things with the range extender because you carry it all the time.
In kaj je najbolj bistveno pri tem?
And the engineer has control, not the driver.
Mazdine Skyactiv X modele smo v praksi spoznavali na bolgarskih cestah. V čudoviti pokrajini in tu v Sofiji smo lahko občutili, kako je bilo nekoč v rimskih časih sprehajati se po centru mesta. No, ceste tukaj so široke, so pa bolj kot za motor napor za podvozje. Kajti, tukaj so luknje na cesti stalnica. Gre za luknjo pri luknji, razlika je samo v tem, kako globoka je luknja. Se pa tudi tukaj zgodi, da je kak prometni znak sam sebi namen, kar pa v bistvu niti ni tako zelo velik problem, ker ti prometne pravila tukaj tako ali tako nimajo prav velike teže. Je pa Bolgarija ena tistih držav EU, kjer je vozni park povsem drugačen kot v Sloveniji. Tukaj je blagovna znamka izredno pomembna. Letnik avtomobila že malo manj, je pa zelo, zelo pomembna tudi oblika avtomobila. In če avto že ni nastopaški terenec, pa je mora imeti vsaj limuzinski zadek. Kako zelo drugače kot pri nas?
Najmodernejše kompresijske motorje Svečko bo Mazda najprej pomodila v trojkah. Poglejte na štest. Motorje, ki varčno zagotavljajo zrevno mešanico, sicer dobite tudi že v CX-5-kah. Ogromno množico MX-5-k pa smo pred časom posneli v Kaliforniji, na slovitem dirkališču Laguna Seca.